Because at the end of the day, we all matter as people. And I'm sorry.
What's up, guys? Ty Rivera here, the absolute best LGBTQ comedian in the world. So I told you guys I was going to talk about that Robert Ortiz apology video. If you guys don't remember who Robert Ortiz was, he was the annoying passenger that was harassing the black Lyft driver. And I'm not going to spend too much more time on this. I just thought it was important because a lot of people on the original video kept hitting me up and being like, where's the apology? Where's his apology? Some people think that somehow I'm connected to this person. So some people were mad at me because the apology hasn't come out yet, which I don't care about that. But at the same time, I was just like, yeah, I don't know this guy. I was just trying to share a story with you guys. I don't know anything about that. So I went ahead and posted the full apology. If you guys want, you can check that out. Just briefly, in his description box for his apology, he put, I disabled comments for this video because we promoting positive and moving forward. I am thankful for the full support and will start touching on how to deal with online bullying and bashing. And that's just because people have been reading you to filth because you fucked up. Like, you feel like you're being bullied and bashed, but of course people are going to be pissed off. The thing that got me about this guy is in his apology, he talks about how it actually happened August, I think 21st, he was saying, which I don't know why they waited from August to October to post the video. Sean Pep was the guy and then did his GoFundMe after that. Maybe that's when Lyft actually decided to do their investigation and suspend him from work for a little while. And he got like, oh, okay, I guess maybe I'm gonna have to release this so that I can A, keep my job, and B, maybe get that GoFundMe money, which I know he raised at least 40 grand. Congratulations to him. He needed that. And some people were like, what's he raising money for? For his legal fund, because if this guy decides to sue him, then that's gonna be a problem. And also, he didn't know if Lyft was gonna keep him. So if Lyft decided to fire him, he needs a way to pay his bills. So he reached out to people that saw the video and he handled it so perfectly that a bunch of people were like, I'm gonna send some money. And that's the way it works. People support what they believe in. And this guy, even to me, I felt like this guy did deserve the help to be able to support his family. In the meantime, well, New York City is an expensive place. So that's what got me about this kid, Robert Ortiz. In his apology, he's like bringing up all the stuff that he's done for his mother and he has to pay her bills. Well, then you know how hard it is out there. So why are you trying to make a man lose his job? A man that ended up, he does have a family, but you didn't know that. You don't know what he had going at home. And here's this man that's trying to take care of his family and just doesn't do the simple request of playing the music for you, which I agree is a simple request, but who knows? Maybe you guys were annoying enough that he just wanted you out of his car. So he was like, I'll get you from A to B, but that's as far as I'm doing. I'm not gonna play your drunk ass music. I'm not doing that. This isn't a rolling party. This is, you're getting from one place to the next. Maybe you were just that annoying. And then this guy, Robert Ortiz, said that he called the police because the driver had called the police first and said that he was being robbed.
I decided to call Lyft and I decided to call the local law enforcement because prior to him recording me, he called the local law enforcement and said that he was being robbed and that we had a gun.
Which I really do feel, as much as you were just spilling everything you could spill and saying he was racist and throwing every accusation and name that you could throw at him, I would think that if he really had called the police on you and said that you guys would try to rob him, I think you would have been on that phone call like, yeah, your driver just called the police and said that we were trying to rob him, which I don't know why you would say that because obviously we're not trying to rob him. So I'm just trying to make sure my bases are covered. I think that's the way you would have handled that. I don't believe that he called the police on you and said that he was being robbed and you didn't bring that up in the tape. And the 16 minutes that you were going on about a bunch of stuff that doesn't even matter and the fact that you voted for Trump, which turned out not even to be true, and you threw up in your own mouth. No, you threw up in your mouth because you're a disgusting person. And there's no apology for a person like you, especially when you're not willing to accept it and you try to lie. And when you lie like that, you're almost justifying it. You're saying that I made this scene in this Lyft driver's car because he had done this to me, but he hadn't done anything to you, or you would have brought it up. I'm sure of that. And you were like, when it affected my job, that's when I realized, yeah, that's, of course you realized once it affected your job. Once you got fired, then you realized what you were doing was totally wrong. What you had done was totally wrong. Before that, it would have just gone in, down in history as one of the nights where you were being crazy, Robert. Oh my God, Robert's so crazy. No, you're fucking up, Robert. And I'm just telling you, woman to woman, that ain't it, Chief. Then you bring up your mom's cancer and how you were had her clear out her living room because you wanted to buy her something for the holidays, or you had bought her something for the holidays. Well, the holidays passed a long time ago. We're already coming up on the holidays again. So I know you didn't buy them for this these holidays because we haven't hit these yet. So if you're talking about close to a year ago, yeah, you should have had your shit together since then. And you should have known, if you're paying so many things, you should know not to be doing this shit. And I don't think you would be apologizing if somebody hadn't recorded. That's the way I feel about it. Like, this wasn't like a sincere from the heart apology. This was a, oh no, I lost my job, so now I gotta make an apology for this. Not doing it with you. I just don't buy it as sincere. Then you mentioned how you didn't need a GoFundMe. Well, good thing you don't need a GoFundMe. Like, why would anybody want to donate money to you? You displayed horrible behavior. And I'm not one of those people that thinks you can't redeem yourself and you can't eventually apologize, but I just think you haven't figured out what it is you did wrong. You still feel like something wrong happened to you. All that happened to you was somebody didn't play your music and you turned into a child. You behaved like a child, and you need to accept that and make adjustments and move on. Not continue to be like, oh, he called the police on us first. No, he didn't. Nobody said that. And I just keep repeating that because it's so annoying when people lie in their apology, when people act like there's still a justification in what's supposed to be an apology. Anyway, that's where I'm at as far as the apology goes. Let me know where you guys are at with it. And like I said, this will be the last time we discuss this unless something huge happens. But this one is done, and that's where I'm at with it. In the next couple days, I'll probably be discussing race because I've had a lot of people tell me that I'm white, which I'll get into it deeper. But I am closer to native than I am to white. I don't know why people keep saying that. It doesn't get under my skin in any way. I just don't understand the logic when people say I'm white, when clearly, if you look at my skin color, if you look at me, if you look at my natural hair texture, I am indigenous. That would be the best way to describe what I actually am, to the point where one of my friends who's light-skinned and Cuban actually called me indigenous, and there was a minute where I wanted to get a little bit offended, but then I was like, we just laughed really hard at that point because I was like, yeah, I am indigenous. So that's that, a little preview of what's coming up. I hope everybody's having a lovely Friday and on your way to a great weekend. This has been Ty Rivera, the absolute best LGBTQ comedian in the world.